Yo, what's up guys? My name is Botlhe, proudly South African guy, a risk taker, a believer of a successful nation, and I'm chilling here with
B. Hi guys, I'm Botlhe Mogwera.
Botlhe.
And I'm chilling here with
I wanna talk to you guys about adventure. Would you take your girl on an adventure trip? Would you take your boyfriend to an adventure trip?
Nah, if I was a guy, I wouldn't take my girl to it. If I was a guy,
yeah,
with a girlfriend like me, I wouldn't even think of it.
Why?
Because I have fears. I have a fear of heights. Yeah, it was just terrible the time I went, but I enjoyed it at the end. Mm-hmm. But it wouldn't be something that I would consider firsthand to do.
It's an indemnity for my person. Better pin. You're sending your life away. Because you can't take the camera from here, no?
Ready?
Oh, man, I'm rolling. Hello, right. What's that, girl? Okay, cool. So that's what happened, guys, man. I took her to an adventure trip, ne? She didn't know where she was going.
Imagine.
She didn't know which direction we're heading. Okay, let me be honest. I didn't know which direction I was also heading. So yeah. Now the thing is, ne? Acrobranch, it's a place that's based in Pretoria North, ne? Pretoria North. So me thinking...
Way north of Pretoria. way north of Pretoria,
like far away.
Yeah, let me
to infinity.
Let me tell you what happened. I wasn't supposed to know where we were going, but because we got lost, I kind of figured that we are both lost and we don't know where we're both going. Yeah, so it was a long ride,
mm-hmm.
and a very expensive taxify ride.
Yeah, it was expensive.
Yeah, because we thought that it was in Pretoria North, so it would be like a 15-minute
drive
to there, which turned out to be like a 45-minute drive.
Oh.
And then we got into the boondos
of Pretoria North, as they
of
call
Pretoria
it.
North. I it's doubt it's Pretoria.
Pretoria North,
but it is, because Mabopane also falls under Pretoria North. This whole side of Pretoria is Pretoria North.
Maybe they should have a name for it.
So yeah, long story short, it was obstacle courses all over. I don't know what we were going to do. We got to reception, we registered and everything, confirmed our appointment, still in the dark, and then we got strapped.
Okay.
We got hooked.
We got hooked. So yeah. The interesting thing for me, ne, when you're going for an adventure, ne, when you're going for an adventure, you need to know your story. You need to know where you're going. So I think for me, one of the biggest mistakes I made is that I thought I knew where Acrobranch was until I had to put on the Taxify, what you call location. So the moment I put on the Taxify location, then the location tells me, no, you're gonna pass some pyramid, what? And I'm like, pyramid? I don't even know any pyramid in South Africa. So now the Taxify driver is asking me during the way, like, cool, dude, since you're going this way, how are you gonna come back from the location where you're going? I think that was
the minute he said that I wanted to go back home with him and be like, please drop us off where you found us. Yes, we're getting there, but how are we going to get back? And it's far.
Imagine if this I was with the Slay Queen.
And now the problem is, I'm thinking, right, we took a turn into the middle of nowhere, mm-hmm. and we took a drive for about 10 minutes, which would be like a walk for an hour 30 minutes or so.
An hour 30.
So even if we can't find a Taxify,
there's still no taxis.
There's still
in general.
No taxis. And then there's no network.
to even
call the Taxify. So we were screwed. But anyway, we kind of forgot about that when we got there.
Yeah.
And I had to face my worst fear of heights.
Yeah.
And then when we got there, we went to the reception.
Mm-hmm.
And because this place is like Adventurous 101, the reception is like in the middle of nowhere. But anyway, we went.
We got lost finding
got
the
lost
reception.
We got lost finding the reception. Trying to find
a
the
basic
reception.
Mm.
We got to the reception and then they gave us indemnity forms. You know, safety above all.
Signing your life away. That's
imagine.
What they meant. That's what they meant.
Imagine. And I signed that. My mind was not prepared to die. I didn't say goodbye to my family.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, I just signed the consent form. And we sign it. And then there's a certain instructor assigned to us. And then we went with the instructor.
Mm-hmm.
And then we did like a 5-minute course thing.
Of which I failed most of the time because I was
and I
hiding
got it right.
myself. I was hiding myself behind the camera. saying anyway. That I'm shooting, but okay. I'm Korean.
Okay, anyway, so we did it, right? And then it was basically to show you how to operate the strings that you are hooked with and how to get about the obstacle course. So we did that for like a good 5 minutes.
Yeah.
And then we went to the obstacle course. Like, yo, if I didn't die that day, I will never die.
Zin, 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 zin.
And we got there.
Someone was scared. She wanted to cry.
And all Bongani wanted to do was shoot. No. And I felt like we should put the camera away because I'm terrified and we can't show people.
What?
Me being terrified.
Why not? You want to see everything.
You know when you conquer your fears, you must be alone in your own private space so that you actually conquer it properly. But anyway.
Let's be honest, were you really scared?
I was. And for the fact that I saw myself taking myself from ground to above ground.
The nice thing is that you get attached to the.
I know you are attached. Like, I know you are attached, but fear is fear.
They told you.
I know.
You can never.
I know you can never fall. I get that and whatnot, but it's a fear. And you being an adrenaline junkie, you won't understand it.
I understand.
No, you don't. You don't, because when you wouldn't mind swinging off. You wouldn't mind falling off purposely because you just want to fly off.
Will I voluntarily fall just like that?
Yes, you would. You would. Anyway.
Yeah.
We got there. And then the first one, we had to climb stairs. Like a ladder, nyana, so. And I climbed. No, first one, I was like, nah, this is easy. Second step, yes, let's do this. Third step, fourth step. And then we came to the fifth step. I was like,
you know, like,
yo, that thing was high. It was just high for me. I couldn't look down because I felt like I was falling. I couldn't look above because I felt like I wouldn't reach it. But I reached it.
But here's the thing.
A good 10 minutes.
Here's the thing. That was a level 2. That was a level 2. Not level 3. Not the red obstacle course.
Yeah.
That was like the easy one.
No,
the easy
but one, I don't the care. Basic one. I don't care. Height. Fall is fall. Anyway.
Yeah.
We got there. And then I had to swing from one pole to another when I got to the top.
Mm-hmm.
And? Like always, you would want to let me go first, which is very unfair. Because when you used to being an adrenaline junkie, you know, you feed off adrenaline and I don't. But fine, I wanted to back out. And then he didn't let me do it.
But here's the thing, no? Once you start off something, you need to finish it off. Like the moment you attach, they told you at the beginning, the only way of getting off, it's as if you finished. There is no quitting in the middle. There is no saying, I want to go back. If you want to go back, fine, you can go back, but it's not going to be easy.
Yes, it's a good life lesson, eh? But at that moment, you just don't care.
Why?
Because your heart tells you, you are dying, get off. You know, that instinct, that sixth sense, it kicked in like, go back because you're dying. But anyway, I did it. Long story short, I started swinging. The hard part was not swinging. It was throwing yourself down to actually swing. It felt like the ropes are not attached to you anymore. And then you have to swing on your own. But anyway, I did it. I swung through like a monkey. Yeah, and then...
Was it comfortable enough for you to say, okay, cool, I'm letting myself flow? I think it was a 5 meter, what do you call it? A 5 meter
slide.
5 meter foofy slide. How was it?
You know when you get to the end and
you're scared.
You're not scared, but you.
And you see your life fading away.
No. When I got to the end, I was comfortable enough to go do the obstacle course again.
Okay.
You know, it was like a moment of conquer. You know, like, yes, I did this, and I'm finishing. And I actually enjoyed the last part more than I enjoyed the rest of the obstacle course because I was scared.
Yeah. For me, when it comes to adventure, it's about the moment you give me a whole new scenario, trees, George of the jungle, you know, all your, you know.
You watch too much TV.
When I was a kid, whenever I finished watching George of the Jungle, I always wanted to go out and make swings inside the house, try to have some robes, and then have something like that. So now, you get to a point where you can actually go on an adventure, actual adventure, and then share it with someone, you know, who's scared. So that gives you more leverage. You say, okay, cool. If she's scared, that means I need to be confident. So that's one thing that you feed off, even if it's negative energy, né? But it's something that you can feed off to say, okay, cool. If she's scared, then I'm not going
to
be scared.
I didn't have energy to feed on because he was laughing at me the whole time. I'm supposed to gain courage. He's supposed to give me courage, but he didn't because he laughed at me the whole time. And he kept on shaking the ropes when I wanted them to stand still. I didn't understand why.
Does weight affect you going on an adventure? Does it matter whether you're this thin, thick, or thin?
It depends.
Does
where
it come?
It depends where you're going.
No, we're going. Let's say on this same one, Acrobranch. Does it matter?
Okay, Acrobranch is doesn't really matter your weight because the obstacle course, it's set in a way that it can take any weight. Mm-hmm. Like that's how strong it is, and you are very safe when you are hooked.
Okay.
So weight doesn't matter because it's the mechanics that they use.
Yeah.
They don't work according to weight, but they work according to movement. Like you just need to be able to move and throw yourself anyway, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So weight is not a problem. Weight is not a factor.
Okay. So another thing when it comes
as
to
as long as you're not young.
As long as you're not young. But yeah, obviously.
As long as you're not underage. But it's quite safe and it's.
What about now? This is the part that I love the most when it comes to shooting this kind of videos. The costs. Would you share with me in terms of the cost of the whole trip?
Any trip I wouldn't mind, but this one, no. Like, why would I?
So
why would
going 50-50 on this
no,
one?
No, why would I pay for something I don't even want to do in the first place?
It's because...
No! I enjoyed it, don't get me wrong. But if you had told me where we got, I'm like, okay, this is where we're going, this is what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
And you want me to keep out my mind for me to go die. No, thank you. I wouldn't see. But I'm kidding, I would.
This is very deep.
I would go 50. I believe in 50-50.
Okay.
Unless it's my birthday and you're like surprised me or something, then I expect you to go the 400. Yeah, but that will be expected of me too on your birthday. Yeah. But yeah, 50-50 is the way.
Okay, cool. One last question when it comes to this. Throughout the whole adventure, né, if you were to take, let's say we're giving advice to other people, if you were to take another, if I'm taking a girl on a trip, on an adventure trip like this, Acrobranch, does it bring me closer to you or does it take me away from you?
It definitely brings you closer to your significant other.
It does.
Even if it's friendship, I think it's a good way of building a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good way of building communication. It's a good way of building trust. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Okay, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you
soon,
hopefully soon, not in 6 months time.
Definitely soon, from now on.
Yeah, soon, not in 6 months time. Sorry for that, guys. But anyway, since we're doing this, né, do the things, like, comment,
hit
subscribe.
The subscribe button
and share.
Yes.
Let's go.
Listen.
Everywhere. Yangani underscore RSA. Let's go.